Typhoon Gaimi or Karina makes its way out of the Philippines. The Weather Bureau says a storm, locally known as Karina, left the country's jurisdiction at 6 this morning. The northern parts of Luzon, however, could still experience rains, with a storm expected to continue enhancing the southwest monsoon. As such, the tropical cyclone wind alert in Batanes province has been downgraded to signal number 1. The signal or wind signals, meanwhile, has been lifted in the Babuyan Islands and parts of mainland Cagayan and Ilocos Norte. Now, disaster response authorities this morning upped the number of reported deaths from the storm to 14, but the number of validated fatalities remains at 8. The NDRRMC also said some 1.1 million persons in 16 regions were affected. The Philippine government orders a price freeze in Metro Manila after the region was placed under a state of calamity due to Typhoon Karina. The Trade Department says the price control covers essential goods including rice, bread, and fresh vegetables, among others. The agency adds it is coordinating with its regional offices in the Metro to monitor the situation and guarantee the availability of essential goods. Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual also warned businesses any attempt to exploit the situation will lead to punishments including imprisonment and substantial fines. The price freeze is automatically in effect after a declaration of a state of calamity. The international community, meanwhile, offers support as the Philippines reels from Typhoon Karina. U.S. Ambassador to the Philippines Mary Kay Carlson says the U.S. Embassy is working closely with local government agencies to provide assistance to those in need. Australian Ambassador HKU also sending sympathies to affected communities. She says Australia is prepared to respond if requested. The Embassy of Canada also says it is closely monitoring the situation. Japan's ambassador, meanwhile, sent his thoughts to the families affected by the calamity. And as for Chinese Ambassador Huang Xilian, he says Beijing stands ready to provide help. The Philippines gets a financial boost that will support green entrepreneurs in the country. The Finance Department says Manila is among the recipients of a nearly 13 billion peso research program. This was approved by the Green Climate Fund Board, the largest global fund created to support climate change mitigation projects. This will allow Filipino green entrepreneurs to leverage global technological expertise and accelerate climate resilience development in the country. The new outlay brings the fund's total grant to the Philippines to more than 137 million pesos, covering 9 projects. A business group lauds President Marcos's move to ban offshore gaming operations in the country in his third State of the Nation address. The Makati Business Club says this proves that Marcos can quickly act on issues hounding the business space. It adds that the POGO ban is among the hits in Marcos's SONA.
The education in TVET. We want to thank President Marcos for integrating TechVoc into senior high. This will help employability of K-12. The second one, if I may, agriculture. Starting with agriculture is the right way of going through all of the sectors of industry. No? The third one is power. Investors, of course, look for affordability and reliability. Especially when you have power-intensive industries like manufacturing. The completion of the critical infra link between Visayas and Mindanao, as well as the president's call for EPIRA, may be timely and maybe an opportunity to create, enable job-creating investments. And lastly, POGO. No? Mm. Thank you, President Marcos, for your immediate action in banning POGOs.